Dubai Index at a decade high.
For details, please call 2717-1771 or visit the Labour Department website.
The vision of Hong Kong 2030 Plus is to make Hong Kong a more livable, competitive and sustainable metropolis.
And in Iran, reports of more deaths as protesters allegedly try to steal weapons from a police station.
Hello and a very good evening. The local stock market started off 2018 with a bang, with the Hang Seng Index gaining 596 points to close at a decade high of 30,515. Stocks of mainland firms listed in Hong Kong led the charge after Beijing kicked off 8-share convertibility reform. Jeff Tan reports.
Investors came back from the holidays in a buying mood after Beijing gave the green light for mainland firms listed in Hong Kong to convert their non-tradable equity into free-floating 8-shares. The move is expected to extend the current bull rally. The Hang Seng Index closed 596 points, or 2% higher, at 30,515. Turnover soared to $126 billion. Technology stocks propelled the benchmark higher. Sunny Optical surged more than 9% to $109.10 as the top blue-chip gainer. AAC Tech jumped 7.5% to $149.80, while index heavyweight Tencent closed up 2.9% at a one-month high of $417.80. Mainland developers were also major gainers, led by Country Garden's 8.3% rise to an all-time high of $16.14. Casino shares surprisingly retreated, despite Macau's announcement that gaming revenue jumped 19% to 265 billion patacas last year. Galaxy Entertainment sank 4% to $60.20 as the worst performing blue chip, followed by Sands China's 2.1% dip to $39.50.
Hong Kong's stock rose to the highest level in over a decade today, added by a surge in property shares as well as China's H-share full convertibility reform, which is generally viewed as a positive to Hong Kong listed Chinese companies. Apart from this, you can see that the total turnover of the market is also rising. So I believe if the momentum of the market is expected to maintain.
The bulls were out in Shanghai, where 20 billion shares changed hands today, compared with December's daily average of 15 billion. Investors were encouraged by a survey showing a rise in factory activity last month. The Shanghai Composite Index jumped 1.3% to 3,349 points. Jeff Tang, TVB News.
A magistrate has found there's a prima facie case against Young Spirations, Sixtus Leung and Yao Wai-Ching, as well as three former assistants on charges of unlawful assembly and attempted forcible entry. Sharon Tang has more detail.
The designated workers for designated skills provision is enforced. Register according to.
你以為招標就有得揀? 我哋一早搞好曬, 你邊有得揀呢?
我哋賺到盡。
And Yao were still legislators. The defense side said Legco security guards committed a criminal offense by preventing the pair from joining a meeting. Without calling Legco President Andrew Leung and the Secretary General of the Legco Secretariat, Kenneth Chen, to testify, defense counsel said they cannot ascertain if security guards were carrying out orders as instructed. Prosecutors argued that Leung and Yao already lost their lawmaker status after they failed to properly take their first Legco oath. As such, whether security guards acted legally wasn't the point. The magistrate rejected the defense's call for more time to look into the case and decided there's a prima facie case against all five defendants. The case has been adjourned until Thursday. Both Sixtus Leung and Yao Wai-Ching haven't decided whether they will defend themselves in court then. Sharon Tang, TVB News.
專業專才教育，入職前我已經學到呢一行嘅知識同技能。畢業後，我可以好快就入工作崗位，工作表現做得到僱主嘅認同。課程嘅專業訓練，令我哋可以喺各行各業發揮所長。專業知識，服務技能，就係你嘅未來。
職業專才。
The Hong Kong Bar Association finally broke its silence last week on the co-location arrangement for the express rail link to the mainland. Its statement specifically focuses on the decision made by the National People's Congress Standing Committee on December 27th. It allows mainland authorities to conduct border control at the rail link's West Kowloon Station in Hong Kong. The Bar Association was not convinced with the explanations provided by the NPCSC. It even said it was appalled that the NPCSC seems to think the proposal complies with the basic law just because it says so. This was criticized by Chief Executive Carrie Lam, who said some legal professionals in the city have a sense of elitism.
The vision of Hong Kong 2030 Plus is to make Hong Kong a more livable, competitive, and sustainable metropolis. First, people search planning for a livable, compact city. Second, diversifying our economy and embracing new challenges. And third, enhancing development and environmental capacity for sustainable growth. Share your views on or before April 30th.
Building owners are responsible for managing the common parts of a building. Owners should attend meetings of the owners' corporation and vote on major issues in person to safeguard their own interests. Active participation in building management benefits all.
Our city moves at a fast pace. But when there's a traffic jam, it costs us time and increases roadside air pollution. It also affects our economy and our daily life. To improve things, we must change our habits. Let's work together. Follow traffic rules at all times. Use public transport and walk instead of driving.
South Korea has offered talks with its northern neighbor amid a standoff over Pyongyang's weapons programs. This comes a day after North Korean leader Kim Jong-un said he was open to negotiations, but Kim insisted Pyongyang would push ahead with mass-producing nuclear warheads. Seoul's unification minister said the proposed talks had been discussed with the United States. Meanwhile, a decision is pending on whether to push back a massive military drill between South Korea and U.S. forces until after the Winter Olympics. Pyongyang sees the drills as preparations for war.
Iranian media have reported that clashes overnight between protesters and security forces killed 9 people, including some rioters who tried to storm a police station to steal weapons. The demonstrations, the largest to strike Iran since its disputed 2009 presidential election, have seen 6 days of unrest across the country and a death toll of at least 20.
Iranian authorities have promised a harsh crackdown on the anti-government protests that have gripped the country these last few days. Today, the head of Tehran's Revolutionary Court reportedly warned that arrested protesters could potentially face the death penalty when they come to trial. Iranian media has reported that around 450 people have been arrested over 3 days of protests in Tehran. No nationwide arrest figures have been released by authorities since the demonstrations began last Thursday. People are taking to the streets to protest against the country's underperforming economy, rising food prices, and alleged government corruption. The demonstrations have seen mass arrests, destruction of property, and multiple deaths. Iranian state television reported today that that 9 people were killed overnight amid the growing unrest. State TV reported that 6 of them were killed during an attack on a police station in the town of Kadirijan. It reported that clashes were sparked by rioters who tried to steal guns from the police station. Iranian President Hassan Rouhani has acknowledged public anger over the Islamic Republic's flagging economy, but he and others warned that the government wouldn't hesitate to crack down on those it considers lawbreakers.
Israel's parliament has passed a law requiring a supermajority to relinquish control over any part of Jerusalem. It's a move that could hamstring the city's division as part of a Middle East peace plan. The amendment passed today bars the government from ceding Israeli sovereignty over any part of Jerusalem without approval from at least 80 of the legislature's 120 members. The law itself can be overturned, with a simple majority making it largely symbolic. The Knesset passed the amendment amid heightened tensions following US President Donald Trump's recognition of Jerusalem as Israel's capital.
Meanwhile, US President Donald Trump has pledged to stop giving aid to Pakistan. That's after he tweeted that Washington has foolishly handed the South Asian country more than $33 billion in aid over the last 15 years without getting anything in return. Trump also tweeted that Pakistan gave safe haven to the terrorists we hunt in Afghanistan and blasted Islamabad for giving the US nothing but lies and deceit. On Monday, a U.S. National Security Council official said the White House does not plan to spend $255 million in aid to Pakistan at this time, and the administration will continue to review Islamabad's level of cooperation. In response, Pakistan summoned the U.S. ambassador and lodged a formal protest, while the country's foreign minister dismissed Trump's outburst as a political stunt.
Boston's Mayor Marty Walsh took the oath of office for a second term as the city's leader with a promise to make the city stronger. Former U.S. Vice President Joe Biden presided over the inauguration at the Cutland Majestic Theater. The Democratic mayor defeated city councilor Tito Jackson in November. Over in New York, another Democrat, Bill de Blasio, began his second term as mayor at a swearing-in ceremony presided by Senator Bernie Sanders. As a national leader in progressive politics, de Blasio said he envisions a city that serves more than the elite and Wall Street titans.
Something big is happening in New York City. Something new, something different. Something that has begun a new progressive era in this city's history. Every one of you are part of it. Something is being done here that matters to all of us, but is also being felt far beyond our borders.
And still ahead on the news tonight: legalized sale of marijuana for recreational use in California, a warning about the safety of LED balloons, and New Year's Day celebrations of the sea.
中成药标签及说明书法例已经了。法例规定香港销售的中成药都要有释放的标签，列明药品名称、有效成分、产地、注册编号、代理或制造商、包装规格、用量、用法、失效日期和批次编号。说明书还要有用来功能和用药禁忌等资料，这样大家服用中成药就更方便和有保障。
包括港币同埋其他货币存款都包噶，香港存款保障委员会以法律保障你银行嘅储蓄，最高港币50万噶。令你存得安心，香港存款保障委员会。
要睇世界级嘅地啊，唔该写，边世坐飞机啊？等我带你去中国香港世界地质公园啦。游地质公园最紧要注意安全。最好由經驗豐富的導遊帶領，大家亦都要小心執法和鬆脫的石塊，不要攀爬石柱或踐踏嚴重風化的岩石，沒有碼頭設施就不要上岸了。還有 其武嶺走石塊畫在岩石上同啱，要保護地質公園的自然景觀啊！
火警時如果屋外好大熱，就留在屋裏面。如果逃生，要帶三寶：手機用嚟求救，毛巾用嚟揞住口鼻，減少刺激氣道。換時必要時可以翻入屋暫避。逃生時見到樓梯有冒煙，就要行另一條。如果所有樓梯都有煙，就要翻入屋。做好保護措施，等待救援。記住，火警逃生要帶逃生三寶：手機、毛巾、換匙。
This shirt is 100% cotton.
Ceremonial ribbon cuttings marked the occasion yesterday as America's biggest producer of illicit marijuana moved from the shadows towards a regulated market. California was the first state to legalize the drug for medicinal purposes back in 1996. Then, 20 years later, California voters made it legal for adults aged 21 and above to grow, possess, and use limited quantities of marijuana. But it wasn't legal to sell it for recreational purposes until Monday.
So with the arrival of state regulations, now we have very prescriptive rules and guidelines. So for us, that helps to create a level playing field. And the intent of all that is to provide the consumers of cannabis with things that they know are safe, are not, you know, grown with dirty pesticides and things like that, and that the proper taxes collected along the whole supply chain. So those are the things that we're most excited about.
Well, here in Hong Kong, an anti-drug committee chairman warned of potential brain damage in taking cannabis.
Simply because it is legalized in another country, it doesn't mean that it's not a drug of abuse, and it still carries a lot of health hazard. Brain imaging studies and also studies in youth using cannabis. There are evidence that it might cause long-term brain damage. I mean, when they grow up into an adult, they might have a decrease in IQ of 8 points.
Macau expanded its smoking ban, so it's now illegal to puff away within 10 meters of bus stops. Smoke-free zones at the city's 400 bus stops have been marked with grey lines. It's now also against the law to smoke e-cigarettes inside those areas. Offenders face a fine of 1,500 petakas. LED balloons were hot items this holiday season, but their safety is under question after explosions on the mainland and in Taiwan. Chiam Sai Choi's waterfront was illuminated by these balloons fitted with LED fairy lights. They cost anywhere between $30 and $100, a hit with both tourists and locals. One seller said they sourced all materials online and filled balloons with helium purchased from local factories. It does matter what was used, as some see these novelty items as ticking time bombs. In recent months, a number of people on the mainland and Taiwan have sustained burns after the balloons exploded. So dangerous that the Taipei and Kaohsiung city governments banned these LED balloons at New Year countdown events. Initial investigations revealed the dangers of inflating them with a cheap but flammable alternative, hydrogen. If balloons are not tied up properly and leak hydrogen, a fireball may result if people are smoking nearby, warned mechanical engineer Lo Kwok Kung. While experts say it's safest to buy balloons inflated with air, this family is simply keep its distance.
A truck turned on its side in Cheung Kwan O this morning, trapping the driver in the cabin. At least five firefighters helped free the driver from the wreckage. The vehicle flipped onto its side after it reportedly hit the curb on Wan Po Road opposite Lohas Park. Waste oil from the truck also spilled out. Traffic towards Cheung Kwan O Industrial Estate was snarled up for hours because of the accident.
Biomedical scientist Rocky Tua today took up his new job as the 8th Vice Chancellor and President of the Chinese University. He said he's excited on his first day of work. Tua, who took over from Joseph Song, earlier vowed to lead by example and respect people's right to agree to disagree. He also expressed his wish to learn what students think about the institution, But this morning, he walked away from questions on when he'll meet them. So, Tony, exciting news stories?
We do. We have sailing and some football. Let's start with sailing. Some of the world's fastest high-performance yachts are heading for Hong Kong. The eight boats in the Volvo Ocean Race left Melbourne's Port Phillip Bay today. The fleet will travel 6,000 nautical miles up the east coast of Australia into the Coral Sea and then head north to Hong Kong. This is the first time sailing's toughest race will visit our historic port. Spain's Matt Frey tops the standings after the third leg. Local entry is Scallywag, led by Norway skipper David Wood, is in fifth place overall. The boats are expected to arrive in the territory in about 3 weeks' time. Some footy news, and Manchester United defeated Everton 2-0 to end a winless run of four matches. Juan Mata led the charge, while Anthony Martial and Jesse Lingard were the goal scorers at Goodison Park. United was missing Romelu Lukaku and Zlatan Ibrahimovic due to injuries. With the victory, the Red Devils moved back into second place ahead of Chelsea. However, the Blues have a game in hand. United trails Manchester City by 12 points. Meanwhile, Jose Mourinho has started a war of words with a Manchester United legend. The Portuguese came to the defence of Paul Pogba after Paul Scholes criticised the player's recent performances.
I think the only thing Paul Scholes does is to criticise. I don't think he comments, I think he criticises, which is a different thing. But, not every one of us has to be phenomenal like he was as a player. He was a phenomenal player. That doesn't mean that we all have to be phenomenal.
On the ice and in the NHL, the New York Rangers defeated the Buffalo Sabres 3-2 in the Winter Classic in New York. JT Miller scored the winning goal 3 minutes into overtime. Goalie Henrik Lundqvist made 31 saves. The Rangers improved their record in regular season outdoor games to 4-0. The NHL's 10th Winter Classic was played at Citi Field, the home of the New York Mets of Major League Baseball. To the NBA, and the Portland Trail Blazers defeated the Chicago Bulls in overtime, 124-120. Portland's CJ McCollum picked up the slack for the injured teammate Damian Lillard. Here's Jameson Wong.
Come on, these teams aren't so bad. The Blazers are actually above 500, while the Bulls led 55-52 at the break. But the cream rose to the rim in the second half. CJ McCollum with the buckets to tie the game at 112 and send it to overtime. The shooting guard scored 32. He was also clutch in the OT. Blazers win 124-120. Portland in the mix in the West, while Chicago near the bottom of the East. Jameson Wong, TBB News.
Thousands of performers from around the world took part in London's annual New Year's Day parade in front of huge crowds. Marching bands and cheerleaders, many from the United States, sang and danced as crowds waving British flags cheered on them. The procession started at noon yesterday at Piccadilly and travelled through the city before ending several hours later at Westminster. Over in the Eternal City, four men took part in a 72-year-old New Year tradition for Romans by diving off the Cavour Bridge into the Tiber River's chilly waters. The men dedicated their stunt to families who are having trouble making it to the end of the month. And in the German capital, Berlin, members of the Winter Swimming Association welcomed 2018 with an alfresco dip in Oranke Lake in different costumes. And that's the news.
Thanks for watching. Have a great night.
In 2018, Dolce Vita will grace the street.